think originally I wanted to tell this story to show what it's like to be an Aboriginal person growing up in this country. I grew up in the 70s and I was born 2 years after the referendum where we got our right to vote and pretty much basically considered to be human beings in this country. And I grew up in the land rights era and trying to find your way through life through a country that's got a lot of racism. Within our community, in the Aboriginal community, we've got a lot of oppressive tools in our community that disjoint us. I'm disconnected from my family at the moment because I could see that within our community, the things that get passed down sometimes aren't always positive. So I wanted to show what that journey might look like. It's not exactly an autobiography of my life. I've taken bits and pieces out of it and created characters that might be able to tell that story.
And it is the story of song. I mean, again, one of the things which really appealed to me when Waiata first approached me about the piece was that she didn't want to tell it as a pure autobiographical work. She has fictionalised the central character. She uses metaphor, she uses imagery, she uses different elements, symbolism like the stones and also the AV images of birds and so on, to tell the story so that there's a kind of spiritual element to it.
I had to make really crucial decisions in my life to be able to have some semblance of quality, peace and love. And in a journey throughout the Australian landscape, to be able to attain that as an Aboriginal person is a really hard task.